Okay, so my presentation, main topic of my presentation is the chemical evolution in the universe. So Kate gave a great presentation of the large scale of the universe. So I follow this presentation, and my topic is concentrate in the galactic scale things. And also, I'd like to explain the relation between the galactic scale things and the chemical evolution, so I mean the things around here. So this is one of the simulation of the galaxy formation. So the following the current concordance model, so the first small scale structure is formed, and then these small structure are merged and form the large scale structures. So here, so the, I show the, so blue means the gas component, and the right point represents the stars. So the first small structure formed, and then they are actively merged and formed a galactic structure like this. So the, yeah, so the, in our model, our universe, so the dark matter is plays a very important role to form the structure. So the first dark matter collapsed, and then the ordinary matter accreted to the dark matter potentials. And the radiation reduces energy from the ordinary matter, so they contract, and then finally form the star in the center of the dark matter potential. That is a galaxy. Okay, yeah, so okay, so this is the content of my presentation. First, maybe the first half of my presentation is used for the general introduction for the chemical evolution. And then so I explained some numerical results we carried out recently. And finally, I give the brief summary of my presentation. Let's start from this, my favorite manga, Japanese manga, Fullmetal Alchemist. Maybe you know this manga, because this is very famous one. So the this is the story of the alchemist. So the alchemist in this story is like the scientist in our world. So yeah, so that he is knowing the many things about the science. So the once they or he tried to back the, her mother using the alchemist. So but. So he knows a lot of the human beings. So in this cut, so he explains the many main components of the human bodies. So the right cut, so he explains the many things used to the human bodies. So even elementary school students know that our body consists of a lot of the elements. But so finally, so they, he failed to back the, her mother, so made this kind of things, unfortunately. So anyway, so the so actually, so this is here is here is abundance pattern of the solar photosphere. So the sun's abundance pattern. So there is a clear trend that the hydrogen is most abundant, and then so decreasing like the exponential function, and then move to the flat part. So there is a so like a so like a structure. So because there are some stable elements have the slightly abundant from the other, like the oxygen, carbon oxygen. Sulfur, silicon, calcium is stable. Also, the iron is very has a very the deepest potential binding potential. So the iron is very stable. So the iron has the other peaks. So yeah. So the these things come from the many a lot of the astrophysical event. So now, so we know this kind of the this is a big table, and so we can put which event makes the which elements like this. I will directly explain further later. And I'm astrophysicist, so the, we are thinking things very simply. So everything except hydrogen and helium is a metal. So the, in the beginning of the universe, so there are only the hydrogen and the helium and a very small amount of the lithium. So this is available network during the Big Bang nucleosynthesis, the very early universe. Because there is no stable element having the mass number of the 6 and 5 and 6, so it's this network stuck this cycle. So this is here is the time from the Big Bang, and here is the mass fraction. So the first almost most of the things are hydrogen and then the helium synthesized, but this reaction stops around here, so the early universe only has hydrogen and helium, and only small amount of lithium. So the others are synthesized during the stellar evolution. So this is one of the cartoon describes the reincarnation of the material. The first gas contract due to the first, due to the gravitational contraction, then radiatively lost the energy, and then formed the stars in gas here, and then formed the stars and also formed the planet. And then so the stars are using the becoming the how to say the main sequence star means these stars are using the most almost 19% of his life using as a main sequence, and then finally stars evolved and formed exotic structures. So one case, so the stars become the giant and formed a white dwarf. And some made the supernovae, and then the part of the material back to the interstellar matter space, and then these are used as a, for the next generation stars. Stellar evolution is strongly dependent on the mass of stars. So yeah, you know, so the here is showing the evolution of the stars as a function of the mass. So the for the case that the very massive stars, so first stars the mass contract and then hydrogen and hydrogen bond and then the helium bond, and this process exceeds and then forms this onion-like structures for the massive stars. And then the final phase is just one day, so silicon to the iron reaction becomes finished just one day. And then the central part of the Fe iron is collapsed due to the photo dissociation process. So then the pressure becomes zero, or almost zero in the center of the star, so the most of things are collapsed, and then bounce them. This is a supernova. And if the, we consider the intermediate mass stars like this, so the one part, part of the stars are moved to the hole. Yeah, so part of the star evolved as a red giant. And then when they lost most of the material, so they become the white dwarf. But if he is like the binary, so they made the binary system, and the end of the evolution, so the one, some case, so the star's companion material from the companion is accreted to the this one, so then the finally explode as a type 2 supernova. The others lost, Roma stars are very simple, just cooling. So the, these diagrams show that there are many places of the element formation. So the, for instance, supernovae is a very short time scale, just 10 to the 7 years, and release most of the material alpha element. Alpha element is a carbon, sulfur, oxygen, calcium, like that. There, in this case, iron is photo dissociated, so the iron release is very small. But so here, the mass loss release low mass, so light element from the outer part of the stars. And then, so the type two supernova, type one is supernovae, mostly release iron. So the time scale is just 10 to the 8 to the 10 to the 10. So it's use a very long time. So when we investigate the abundance pattern of the galaxy or stars, we can reconstruct when these stars are formed by comparing the elemental pattern, the abundance pattern. So this picture is established very, almost 60 years ago. Well, more than 60 years ago. This is a very famous one. So the this whole review describes the that I showed the previous slide. But yeah, so this is a very famous work study, and so even in my textbook in the high school, so this kind of things are described. But recently, so that's slightly changed. So the, for instance, the heavy element, most of the heavy element are synthesized during the supernovae, the people are considered this age. But very recently, so the high resolution simulation of the supernovae tells that it is very difficult to form the this to synthesize the heavy element because the in the supernova remnant, so it is very hard to make the nitrogen, neutron rich environment. So it's very difficult to make the R process, so R processing rapid neutron capture process to make the unstable element. So people consider that it might be difficult to synthesize almost all R process elements in the supernova. So there are many alternatives, but very recently, so the people consider that this might be carried out by the synthesized by the neutron star merger. Oh, this is GW170817. Oh, this is a first optical counterpart of the gravitational wave. So this is a neutron star merger. So yeah, so here there is a two neutron star merger, neutron star binaries, and then they merge. So they emit the gravitational waves and also emit many lights. That's unlike the black hole case. Black hole binary merger doesn't emit any electromagnetic counterpart. So this is a here is the time, and this is the band. So the first gravitational wave are detected, and then a gamma ray, X-ray, UV light, optical, IR radio. So there are many bands observed in this event. So this is very important. So because using some models, so we can, if we can put the fit this light curve perfectly, so we can reconstruct the environment of the neutron star mergers. So this is that one of that case. So the Tanaka-san doing that. So the, using his model, so the this electron fraction is favored to reproduce all light curves. This means that this is the electron fraction. So this means that this value is small. Means that there are a very neutron-rich environment. So R process can be possible in this environment. Of course, there are many other indirect or direct evidence of the R process error synthesis. Okay, so we can back to this periodic table. So the, before this event, so people doesn't believe the merger of neutron star is so important. So the old periodic pattern of this one doesn't hold the neutron star merger. But now, so we believe that the neutron star merger is very important to synthesize the main element, so R plus element. Okay, but so the, yeah, you know, so here is a Big Bang nucleosynthesis. At that time, the metal is zero. But now, so we have the, this kind of pattern. Stellar evolution is very important during this path, but it takes 13.7 giga year, so it's very long time from here to here. So we need to, it's very difficult to just reconstruct this relation. So, yeah, but for instance, so the, yeah, we, our body is, there is a six important element like the S, P, O, N, C, H, sponge. When these materials are synthesized, it's very important to understand how to life is emerged. But it's not easy to expect from here to here. So now, so we are using the galaxy formation simulation, you know, to assess when the, how these materials are enriched during the through the for. Time of the age of the universe. So from here, so I'd like to explain some results. But I skip here because I don't have enough time. So yeah, so that's rather maniac things. Okay, so europium. So the europium is one of the R process elements. Maybe you don't familiar with europium because this is mainly used like the dark paint. Europium emits some light. So when you use the dark paint, that is including the europium. Yeah, so this is one, this one. So yeah, so the, this is, yeah, looks like this. And one of the important things is most of the europium comes from the R-plus element. So the, when we study the distribution of europium, so we can understand the origin of the europium and also origin of the R process. So this is the distribution of the europium. This is yeah, here is a metallicity, the iron over hydrogen. So this part is a current. This part is a very synthesized early phase. So this is the europium over Fe values normalized by the solar value. So, so you can see that's some simple trend like that. So from here there's a big variation. From here, so the, there might be plateau and then so reduce a decreasing trend. So this decreasing trend is due to the type 1 supernovae that release a lot of the iron. So the, this evolving like that. But now, so we are focusing on this part, this part, large variation. Because this might include the early phase of the universe and also including the information of the early phase of galaxy formation. So this is one of the previous studies. So the, they study the neutron star over the supernova, which is the best to reproduce observed distribution of the European or the R process element. So red is the distribution of the stars, and black is the distribution of their simulation. So they compared these two models, and they failed to reproduce the distribution of this one using the neutron star mergers because of the longer delay time and the low efficiency, and also the high star formation efficiency in this model. So the people might consider that so this is very difficult, so neutron star merger might not be important at that time. But Ishimaru-san, so she studied slightly different model. So previous one is just consider the one thing, yeah, they consider the mixing, but that is rather, they consider the one galaxy. So Ishimaru-san considers the building block of the galaxies. The galaxies are consisting of the small part of the galaxies. So she considers that the small part of construction, cluster of small galaxies might reproduce these structures. The previous case, so the European enhancement curve like this. So how to explain this part? But Ishimaru-san's case, she can reproduce this part. That's a big improvement from the previous one to this one. But this is just not a numerical simulation of the dynamics. Doesn't include this model. So we are trying using a dynamical model to explain the low-metallicity high European dispersion. Okay, we'll just move to the result. So this is a result of the final result of the European distribution. So here is the FE over H. This means the indicator of the metal. So this is the solar value. Here is a very low metal and very high, let's see, high early universe material. So in our model, so we can reproduce this deep dispersion because the inhomogeneity in in a galaxy is very important. And if so, we ignore the mixing or the adapting the very long times, major time scales that fail to reproduce the observation. But some fiducial model can reproduce this one. So we finished this study before the direct detection of the neutron star margin. So the chemistry is very important to learn the how a galaxy are formed. So, but next, so I'd like to introduce our study of the galactic habitable zone. This is a very preliminary result. So, yeah. So, galactic habitable zone that is things that's a habitable region in the galaxy. Both the distance from the galactocentric distance and also the time from the formation of the galaxy. This is a famous figure of the line wave of 2003. So here is the galactocentric distance. So it's here, and this is the time. Here is now, and here is the formation epoch of the galaxy. So the very early phase in the center of the galaxy, so there are the main active star formation. So how to survive? Because there are main supernovae. Here is slowly evolving, but here is hard to make the planets because of the very low metallicity. So sweet spot comes around this region. The sun is here. So sun is almost in the center of this sweet spot using this model. But this case, so mainly consider the G, metallicity. But there are the many components in the universe, so G should be expanded from C, O, magnesium, silicon, Fe, or something like that. So for instance, the C over O ratio might change the world. If the O rich environment, so there is a water world. But if the C rich environment, so that becomes the carbon world. C over SI ratio might change the dust properties. Magnesium, silicon, iron over O ratio change the structure of rocks. Also, the sponge, abundance of the sponge is so related to the life. So, using the, my software library of the chemical evolution and the simple multi zone model, this case doesn't include the dynamics. So we can reproduce the observational value of the current Milky Way distribution of the metals, like this, using this simple relation. But it's not perfect because maybe those amount of the prediction of the release amount of the, for instance, magnesium or P is so insufficient. So yeah, of course, our model needs to have the room to improve, but also there might be the room to improve in the yield. The simulation result of the supernovae or some other event. Now, using this kind of model, so we have the mean abundance of the each radius and different epoch. So this is a very preliminary result, so please do not distribute But when we use the equilibrium condensation model of the Saitoh et al. 2015, so we can evaluate, for instance, iron to silicon ratio, the water mass fraction, just solving the relation between the elements and the condensed matter. So for instance, so the solar is here, sun formation point is here. That is rather water-rich environment. If so, solar sun is born in very center of the galaxy, it's very water deficit region. This kind of deviation we can reconstruct. We need to check further. So yeah, just very preliminary result. Please do not believe everything. And next, last one is the paleoclimate and the solar motion deviation. This case of chemical evolution doesn't consider, so this is very other simple models. So yeah, so you might know the Spencer hypothesis, that the cosmic rate change the amount of cloud resulting in the climate change. Maybe so the cosmic rate so change induce trigger the ice age. But this is very tentative, just a simple hypothesis. The possible reason of the cosmic ray increase is solar activity, change of solar activity, or change of the terrestrial magnetism, or the solar local environment considered. So the, when we so he mainly considered the last one. So the solar is here. So the, there is a spiral arm. When the solar passes the sun passes the spiral arm, so star formation activity very high in the solar, so there is a periodic enhancement of the star formation, the cosmic ray, and this might lead to the periodic ice age. So here is a ice age pattern. This is the longest ice age period, that is 140 megaeons. That is very long. So it's much longer than the Milankovitch time scale. So this should be related to the galactic scale something. So he considers that there is a steady spiral arm, and the sun passes continuously, periodically, so this pattern might be reconstructed. But the recent simulation doesn't show the pattern of the spiral arm. So spiral arm is very recurrent. So some spiral arm are formed, then the part of the spiral arm dissolved, and then other spiral arm is contacted. So the spiral contains a periodic path of the spiral arm is not realistic, I think. So this is one example of a high resolution simulation of the Milky Way. So the, this red part is the sun-like stars. So this is, for instance, this is the distance from the center of the galaxy. You can see this pattern. This is the closest part, and this is the longest part. So this comes from the excitable motion of the stars. So that was determined by the galactic potential, just the galactic potential. So the, this period is almost 150 megaeons in the solar radius. So this might be related to the climate change, but of course there is a many big gap between the Earth environment and the galactic environment. So we need to show further, we need consider further evidence is necessary to say concrete things. Okay, so this is a summary of my presentation. So the first, the in our universe are metallized synthesized by the stellar evolution. So recent progress shows that the quark-quark supernovae are not necessarily seeded for the R process side. And neutron star merger are suitable for the R process, the synthesis of the R process element. You know, this drastically changed. And we are studying the R-plus formation process, site of the process element using the neutron star merger model, and we can reproduce observation using some fiducial parameters. And finally, so I'd like to mention that the simulation, galaxy simulation is very powerful to measure the habitability or to understand the emergence of the life, I think. That's all. Thanks.
Any questions from the audience to start us off before we go to the Slido? Mm-hmm. You're ready for it.
So we heard earlier that the universe is expanding symmetrically about us. And if I understood your talk correctly, the elemental distribution in the periodic table can be sort of used as an age measure. If we average over all stars in a galaxy, the elemental distribution should be a measure of the age.
Yeah.
If we look around our universe, would we expect to see the same elemental distributions?
It depends on the
expanding universe, or would we find regions that were older?
First of all, the expansion of the universe doesn't import in the galactic scale.
But if we look very far away, we're going to see a very simple periodic table. And if we look in our galaxy, we see the periodic table we keep.
It's very difficult, so we cannot know everything of the element. Every element. We can not measure every of the element outside of the, our galaxy.
Oh, I know we
can't
do it.
But in some case, so the... it might be... So it's very difficult. So I think that we only know the local.
Yeah, no, I know. I mean, technologically, we can't do that. I'm just wondering whether we would expect a symmetric universe with regard to elemental distributions.
So in order to measure the amount of the metal, so we need to know the absorption line. So detailed absorption line is necessary. So, but it might be limited to only the sun or something. In theory,
we could do it.
Uh-huh.
Would we expect to see our neighboring galaxy
in the That's a very interesting question. So I can answer, but maybe. So it depends if we have the nuclear-like galaxies, and if we consider the similar part. So for instance. So sun is from the 8 kiloparsecs from the center of the galaxy. So we got the data stars from the 8 kiloparsecs from the other galaxy. It might be it's difficult because radial migration is also very important. So stars are very migrated from center to outside, outside to center. So it's not easy to mention the birthplace. So if birthplace change, so current position doesn't important to reconstruct the periodic table or the formation history of the region. So in that case, so it's not easy to. Yeah, but if a star, there are stars that have similar evolution in galaxy, so that might have the same, almost identical pattern, I think.
Let's take a question from the Slido behind you. Let's take Tony's. So recently, a large cache of rare metals, including europium, which was formed in the R process, was found on a small island in Japan. It's very good for lots of yen. Are all of these rare metals produced together? Tony, do you mean in the same region of space?
Oh. Same event?
Region, same region, same process. Why are they all clustered together?
Of course, there is a many minor variation. But for instance, some R-process reproduce not only the European, but also platinum, gold, or some other families. So that they should have the same, or almost same. And also the observation tells that the distribution of the R process element have the universality. So local region and the other region have a similar R process element pattern. So they might have the similar things.
So it should be expected that when you find one, you find many of the others together.
But that's how to say. So this is it's there are many processes from the galactic scale to the Earth. So there might be a big gap between the distribution.
Anyone else in the audience? Otherwise, I'm going to go to my own question. So I decided to ask the system. What in your simulations you put in, you know, neutron star collisions to get the R process metals, but could you go the other way around and say this is the abundances we see of these elements, therefore this must be the frequency of neutron star mergers?
It might be possible. So because the R process have the distribution plus R process family have the universality, and so if this is concrete, so the total amount can predict the frequency, because the one as neutron star merger, we know that each or individual neutron star merger is this amount of the Arbus element.
Thanks. Any last questions? If not, let's thank Saitoh again.